We've got some big news coming off the Christmas break. The Penguins have re-signed forward Jake Guentzel to 5 years worth $6 million per year. I've been seeing a lot of comments saying that Jake Guentzel is overpaid, and I just don't see how. How can you think Jake Guentzel is overpaid? He's 24 years old, has had 3 seasons in the NHL, and in his first season, he put 33 points in 40 games, 16 goals. So that's, if he played the full season, he would have put for sure 60 points, maybe 30 goals, and that would have been in his rookie year. And then following in the same playoff run in the same year, he goes on and he scores, I think, 13 goals. Yeah, he put up 13 goals, 21 points in 25 games, and helped the Penguins win the Stanley Cup. So that's all in his first year. And then the following year after that, which was last year, he put up in a full 82-game season, he put up 22 goals, 48 points. So again, I can see why you're a little bit disappointed in that. But again, he put up 20 goals and, you know, almost 50 points. And don't forget, the Penguins started off really bad last year in the beginning. They really picked it up in January. And then to follow it up, he had one of the best playoff runs I've ever seen by a player his age in my whole life. He put up 10 goals in 12 games and 21 points in 12 games in just 2 rounds. So if they went on to win the cup, he would have put almost 30 something points in his second playoff run. And then coming into this season, he's got 33 points in 36 games, almost point per game, and he's got already 15 goals. You know, he's gonna score 30 something goals. He's gonna get 70 something points unless there's some sort of injury or slump that comes. So unless that happens, he's gonna have a breakout season this year, and it's worth $6 million. And I think, you know, he's only 24. He's gonna keep this up. He's gonna get better. He hasn't even fully hit his prime yet. He's gonna be putting, in my opinion, consistent 60 point seasons for the rest of his contract, because he is a good player. In just his first two playoff runs, he's got, in 37 games, 23 goals and 42 points. That right there is good enough for some players in their whole career. Jake Guentzel has that in his first 2 seasons, and he's only getting better, hasn't even hit his prime yet. And just to say this, Jake Guentzel is a part of the Penguins core right now. Whether you like it or not, he's a core player for the Pittsburgh Penguins. When I look at the Penguins core, I look at Sidney Crosby, Evgeny Malkin, Chris Letang, Phil Kessel, and then Jake Guentzel, followed by, after that, maybe Brian Dumoulin, you know, maybe Matt Murray, whatever, you know, Patrick Hornquist. But the top five are those guys right there. Jake Guentzel is getting paid like a top five player on the Penguins. I'm not mad at the contract at all. And just to show you how he matches up against the other core players of the Penguins. So we have Sidney Crosby, who's 31 years old, making $8.7 million for the next 7 years. Evgeny Malkin, who's 32 years old, who's going to be making $9.5 for the next 4 years. Chris Letang, who's 31 years old, is going to be making $7.2 million for the next 4 years. Phil Kessel, who's 31 years old, is going to be making $6.8 million for the next 4 years. And now Jake Guentzel, who's 24 years old and is going to be making $6 million for the next 5 years after this one. And also, I've been seeing a lot of people, you know, wondering how the Penguins have this type of money to be throwing around. Well, let me tell you a little secret here. It's not really a secret, but no one realizes it, that the Penguins are doing something smart. They don't overpay their core players. Their entire core, I would argue, is underpaid, unlike a team like Chicago, who's overpaying for their core. Well, I wouldn't say Kane is not overpaid, but Taves is overpaid. You know, the Penguins are, like I said, underpaying for their entire core. Sidney Crosby, 8.7. He's underpaid by like $5 million. Evgeny Malkin at 9.5. He's underpaid. Phil Kessel at 6.8. He's underpaid. Chris Letang at 7.2. I wouldn't say he's underpaid, but then you look at what Drew Doughty's making and what Erik Karlsson is going to make. Chris Letang is underpaid, and people, they don't realize that. Chris Letang, what he makes, 7.2, is amazing. He's worth every penny of that. And then we have Jake Guentzel making $6 million, who, it could look like a good contract at year 3, year 4 of this deal, because he's only getting better. So the Penguins could afford to throw this money around because they don't overpay their top guys. I think they're all underpaid or just paid perfectly, and they can afford to pay their bottom six. And that's how the Penguins won their 2 cups back-to-back. Their top guys weren't overpaid. They were actually underpaid. Another team you can throw in there is the Tampa Bay Lightning, right? They've underpaid their entire core for a long time too. So I could definitely see Tampa going on a dynasty. I already think they should have had at least 1 cup by now, but they've had terrible luck facing, you know, the Penguins, the Capitals, and Chicago. They faced the team that's won the cup every time. So they're right there. I could see Tampa winning the cup. But anyways, that's for another day. This is a Penguins channel. So from what I've read so far, 90% of the Penguins fans think he's paid perfectly, which is the smart thing. Most of the guys who think he's overpaid are other teams' fans. A fan base I've seen a lot of is the Toronto Maple Leafs. They think Jake Guentzel's overpaid. So for that, let me actually bring this little stat. So I'm just going to read this stat off my phone because it's way too many numbers to remember off by heart. So okay, so William Nylander has 48 goals, 135 points, and 185 games for the Leafs before he signed his contract. Jake Guentzel has 53 goals, 114 points, and 158 games with the Penguins. So Nylander averaged a goal per game of 0.26. Meanwhile, Gensel had 0.34. And William Nylander had a point per game pace of 0.73. Meanwhile, Jake Gensel had 0.72. So Jake Gensel and William Nylander are pretty much even right there. Goal per game, Gensel's more. And point per game, he's right there with Nylander. And then you have the argument of, oh, but Gensel's playing with Crosby. But Nylander's also playing with Matthews. So you can't use that argument there. And don't forget, Jake Gensel destroys William Nylander in the playoff categories. And I didn't even bring that up. So I think $6 million is perfectly fine. Meanwhile, William Nylander is making 6.9. And just for the record, I do think Nylander is the better player than Jake Gensel. I only brought this up because I saw quite a bit of Leafs fans, you know, clowning the Penguins for overpaying Jake Gensel when, you know, you can make the same argument for overpaying Nylander. I think both players are paid perfectly fine. Jake Gensel is not overpaid. I think it's a great deal for both parties. Oh, and one more thing. A lot of people think that Jake Gensel is a product of Sidney Crosby. And I just want to say you couldn't be more wrong by saying that. You know, I think without Crosby, he's a 50-point guy, maybe even 60-point guy, and a, you know, consistent 20-goal scorer. But obviously, playing with Crosby is going to help him out, right? Because you can make the same argument with Rantanen and Kucherov, right? Like, Rantanen's a product of MacKinnon, Kucherov's a product of Stamkos. I don't think that, but you can make the argument. But obviously not, right? Rantanen's a great player on his own. Kucherov's a great player on his own. But when they play with, you know, Stamkos and MacKinnon, they're even better together, right? Just like Gensel with Crosby. And it's not just one way. You know, Crosby gets helped out by Gensel too. Crosby gets those extra points because Jake Gensel is a great player. Just like MacKinnon gets, you know, helped out because of Rantanen. And, you know, same thing with Stamkos and Kucherov. It's not just, you know, Crosby helping Gensel. You know, it's a big part of that. But I also think Gensel helps Crosby. You know, I don't think Crosby needs any help. But you know what I mean. Gensel's a great player and fits with Sidney Crosby. And I think it's going to be a great duo for years to come. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what you thought of the Jake Gensel contract. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Did you think it was okay? Is he overpaid? Is he underpaid? I want to hear all that in the comments. And the Penguins play in 3 minutes. So let me wrap this up. Go post this video and watch the Penguins, you know, back from the Christmas break. Give me your thoughts on the video, like I said. And thank you guys so much for watching.